Hi everyone, my name is Yu Xinnan, and here is my poster for final year project guided by Associate Professor Ong. First, for the introduction. Recent years, with the increasing demand for hydrogen, people are paying more attention to photocatalytic methods, for which the graphitic carbon nitride photocatalysts are widely used for its advantages of moderate band gap, good stability, and earth-abundant nature. However, we cannot ignore its disadvantages of poor light absorption at long wavelengths and high recombination rate of photo-generated electron hole pairs. This can be solved by vacancy introduction. So our problem is, what's the effect of vacancies on the performance of graphitic carbon nitride nanosheets in photocatalytic hydrogen production? This is verified through both experimental and simulation methods. For experimental part, we use urea as a raw material to synthesize pure graphitic carbon nitride, then colorize the structure by TEM, XRD, and FTIR. Then, based on the structure we obtained, we conducted the simulation in Material Studio. The first step is the geometry optimization, then the calculation of band structure and dots is continued, followed by the formation energy calculation. Finally, we got the gap-free energy of hydrogen adsorption. For the results, the TEM image here shows that our product is a 2D mass porous structure. This is also verified by the XRD pattern here. Besides, for the FTIR pattern here, the peak at around 800 on the horizontal axis refers to the out-of-plane bending of hypertizing rings. This proves that our product is hypertizing-based structure. For the band structures, among all structures, carbon tube vacancies deliver the most narrow band gap, and the nitrogen vacancies all give rise to defect levels. Both the defect levels and the narrow band gap are beneficial to the light absorption and further facilitate photocatalytic hydrogen production. The existence of defect levels can be seen more clearly from the dots. Then we further calculate the formation energy. We selected the two structures with the smallest values of formation energy to further conduct the simulation of hydrogen adsorption model. From these three figures, we can compare their gap-free energy, and the carbon tube vacancy delivers the most ideal hydrogen adsorption site with a gap-free energy of negative 0.04 eV. So in conclusion, vacancies tend to narrow the band gaps of photocatalysts, and also nitrogen vacancies tend to introduce defect levels. Besides, carbon vacancies deliver the best hydrogen absorption site, while for nitrogen vacancies, the absorption of hydrogen is favored, but desorption is difficult. So that's all. Thank you.